The conventional story, Amenhotep III, 3,400 years in the past, built it. It was a huge complex here, funerary complex also. But now let's go back to the main five questions in archaeology. What is this? Who? When? How? And why? Deception starts with the names. Colossi of Memnon. Memnon was the king of Ethiopia, which has nothing to do with this particular site. He lived during the Trojan War. He went there to help fighting Greeks. By the way, he lost. So it has nothing to do with this particular name. When 3,400, Amenhotep III, what are the proofs? Well, let's look from the construction point of view. So we have two huge statues. One is still in one piece. The other one, obviously, from the waist up, it was heavily damaged. This material here is a quartzite sandstone. The quarry is near Cairo. It is 675 kilometers from here. This particular piece is almost 20 meters high. You can count the mass. About 5 meters by almost 4 meters, 3.5. Actually, it's exactly 18 meters. So it is over 600 tons in mass. 3,400 years ago, simply there was no technology to shape and to transport this to here for so many kilometers. There was not. So Amenhotep III and his time is not the author of this monument. So this is where Egyptology really starts to falsify the history. Mm-hmm. There are many monuments that do belong to Egyptian pharaonic times. As a matter of fact, everything what was built after it, the massive walls, some funerary enclosures, yes, they do belong to the specific pharaonic times, whether it is 18th dynasty, and even on some other places, we could see that they were able, like for example yesterday, Dendera. You could see those massive walls, but they were built from the mud bricks. Mud bricks is something that you can make. It's been made even today. It's been made for thousands of years. You make thousands and hundreds of thousands of mud bricks, put them together, you build the walls. It's a huge project, but it is achievable. Then when we went to, for example, Edfu, you could see sandstone blocks, half a ton, 2 tons. Yes, they could move them. When we went to Abydos, we could see, you know, some blocks reaching 6, 7, 8 tons. Yes, Egyptians, Romans could do that. When it comes to hundreds of tons, they were not the authors. When it comes to places like Abu Simbel, no way that they could cut it with the laser precision in the stone hill, such a beautiful face. When it comes to the Abydos, that Osirian, they call Osirian, huge granite blocks. No way that they could cut them so perfectly, move them and erect them over there. When it comes to Colossi of Memnon, no way that Egyptians from their most recent times, they could do that. We need to go back deeper in the past to what we call either demigods or the gods, because they had technology, they had time to do that. We will be seeing places like today, Luxor and Karnak, when we can see generations and generations of the pharaohs getting pieces of temples or enclosures or statues. So it was not like everything was done at one time. It was time after time that they were adding to those complexes. Here, the first pieces are actually the oldest pieces, because they are the most superior. And the story will repeat again with the topic of the pyramids. The oldest pyramids are the biggest and the most superior. Everything that came later, 12th dynasty, 19th dynasty, you know, mud brick pyramids, they are inferior. And this is what is so obvious here. Unfortunately, you go to internet, the first 5 or 10 sites are Wikipedia or Wikipedia related sites. So what they do, they completely falsify the history. And maybe we are one of the last generations who can think freely. Everything that will follow in the future, you know, people's brain will be totally washed out.
Yeah.
So enjoy this moment. But this one is still here. It was made in one piece, not 20 pieces put it together. One piece made, one piece transported, in one piece erected. Unfortunately, what we do know from the historical records, more than 2,000 years ago, it was a devastated earthquake. And then again, about 2,030 years back, in the time when the Romans first came here, another huge earthquake. They completely destroyed the complex, all the walls, all the enclosures, all the smaller statues. This one to my left, the waist up, it was destroyed. There are huge cracks in what was remaining. Now, based on those cracks, we know that, especially from the Roman and ancient Greek documents, that during certain months, especially February and March, you could see the humming sound coming from the remaining parts of the statue. So people were, you know, saying or calling them singing statues of men singing. Unfortunately, even that phenomenon has stopped in the recent time and they cemented out, so no more singing. Now, it seems that ancient Romans tried to put the statues back together. They are trying, you know, to get all those pieces damaged from the earthquakes back together. So now we have, we have more or less the statues in the original setting. So enjoy this site, try to connect it maybe shortly, and you will realize that the answers offered by conventional science is not right. Now, I do have respect for the last 200 years of Egyptology, because there are many hard-working Egyptologists and archaeologists who have done a great job. The whole new sciences were actually established, Egyptology, and then generations of geologists were learning from this experience. But unfortunately, when it comes to the chronology, it is not science anymore. It is politics. They want to place the chronology the way they want to do it, so they can easier control us. If they show that we are in the infant stage, just 2,000 years old, it means we need to rely on our elites. We need to give our rights to our elites, because we are so young. We are still babies. But we are not. We go back for hundreds of thousands of years. We got so many experiences with the other civilizations also. If we go back deep enough, just 50,000 years back, human civilizations had very profound, very deep experiences on in spiritual aspects. They were able to get very advanced knowledge. And they were aware that our life is not just this physical life. It was also about the soul. That entity is almost forever. If you have entity that lasts forever, there is no need for fear. Unfortunately, everything in our civilization is based on fear. Fear of losing the job, fear of losing money, houses, loved ones, and so on. Once we realize that there is no need for fear, and the genesis of all fears is fear of death, but once we realize no need for fear, we become free. And there were civilizations before us that they had that knowledge. The real builders of those statues, Abu Simbel, Giza pyramids, and so on, they were free. They had the knowledge, they had access to spiritual knowledge. So this is the place where we are taking you, where you can, you know, experience such a powerful sight. You are very close to those demi gods and gods. And this is one such place. The rest of the trip today, mostly it will be pharaonic times, but this is the place that precedes pharaonic times. Thank you.
Yeah.